Do you often get irritated when you're trying on clothes in the changing room and all you can focus on is your belly fat? I know, been there, done that. Today I'm going to help you with that. Yes, you heard me. Hey guys, today I will show you a 5-minute flow workout that will help you reduce your belly fat. But make sure you follow our rest of the routines to get better results. So, now let's get started. Our first exercise is suitcase crunches. How to do it? To start with, lay back on your mat with your knees at a 90 degree angle off the floor and hands placed on either side of your ears. Crunch your legs towards your chest and as you lower your upper body to the floor. Then crunch them back in again, bringing your knees towards your chest. Now, all you need to do is follow me. So, are you ready? 3, 2, 1, let's get started. Suitcase crunches primarily work on all the core muscles, including the abdominals and the obliques. This provides benefits such as a stronger core, toned abs, and a flatter stomach. It also brings with it the benefits of better stability, mobility, strength, and balance. The movement also helps improve hip range of motion and flexibility. Suitcase crunches also require the back to stabilize and support the movement as you bring your legs in. The hamstrings and quads are also required to bend and straighten the legs during the movement. Our next exercise is supine leg circles. How to do it? For this, lie flat on the mat with arms by your side. Lift your legs up to 90 degrees and using your abdominal muscles, perform slow, controlled circles. Remember to keep your lower back in contact with the floor. Now, it's time for you guys to follow me. Let's get started. You know, when I was researching about supine leg circles, I found out that primary muscles worked by this exercise is the hamstring. Along with the core, the supine leg muscle strengthens the quadriceps and hamstrings. It also promotes a healthy hip joint. It also helps on your abdominal muscles. It also releases tightness in knee joints and develops strong hamstrings. This can help reduce upper back pain, neck pain, and can help you strengthen upper back muscles while opening tight chest and shoulder muscles. If you sit at a desk, this pose is certainly for you. If you have any injury to your knees, hip, or back, you should avoid the supine spinal twist. It should not be painful to perform this exercise, but if you have back pain or knee pain, release the pose slowly. The next exercise to reduce belly fat is V-sit hold. How to do it? To start this, sit up straight with your knees bent, feet on the floor and arm extended in front. Lean back and extend your legs up so your body creates a V shape. Hold and yell. Hold some more. It's time for you to follow along with me. Are you ready? Let's go. You know, I found out that V-sits build strength in multiple areas of the core while also improving your balance. Now, for this exercise, posture is the key. So try to maintain a good posture and as you reach upwards. During a V-sit, you're targeting your rectus, abdominals, external and internal obliques, and hip flexors as well. It is great for coordination and helps in building abs. Doing V-sits with improper form can lead to back pain or even injury. Also, rounding your upper back or shoulders will put more strain on the lower back, so be mindful about that. The next exercise is jackknife. How to do it? For this, lie face up, legs extended and lifted off the ground and arms stretched out behind you. Crunch your legs towards your chest and bring your arms forward to travel past your feet. Now, repeat. Now it's time to follow me. Are you guys ready? Let's go. This exercise is designed to strengthen your upper and lower abdominal muscles, particularly the transversus abdominis muscles. It also tones your arms and stretches your back and shoulders. Now, guys, it is very important to keep your neck and chest released towards the floor and your shoulders away from your ears. Your weight should always, always be on your shoulders and not on your neck. And your power should always come from your core. However, if you have shoulders, neck, or back problems, then you can avoid doing this exercise. There are a number of variations of jackknife exercises that allow people of different age groups and abilities to work their abdominal muscles. I know, guys, getting rid of belly fat can be quite tedious, but if you consistently follow a routine, you can get there. Make sure you consult a medical practitioner before trying this at home to know what is right for you. The floor exercises we spoke about today can help strengthen your core and tone your abs, giving them more definition. However, guys, please remember that you can't target fat burn. If you want to lose belly fat, chances are you're going to lose fat in other parts of your body as well. To burn fat, including belly fat, fast, I advise you guys to focus on strength training in all areas of your body as well. But as I always say, it's important to pair your workouts with a healthy diet. Now, if you feel that this workout is a bit difficult for you, then worry not. Keep watching this space as we will be sharing more workout routines to help get rid of belly fat.